Sviluppo e validazione di metodi per il monitoraggio FAS su campioni di aeriformi. E così tocchiamo anche un altro topic.
Sì. Thank you very much. This presentation is working in cooperation with two agencies, ARPA Piemonte. ARPA Piemonte and ARPA Veneto together. Come va? Va bene? Si sente? My name is Marco Fontana. I am the director of the ARPA Laboratory of Turin. Our laboratory has an important activity on determination of air pollution. You can consider that Torino is one of the worst cities in Italy for this problem. And we are trying to understand how the knowledge of the concentration of a particulate is very limited knowledge of the situation of air pollution. Now, in Italy, also in Europe, in other countries, we make a lot of analysis kind of to understand the toxicity of a particulate. So we have regulations for heavy metals, we have regulations for PAH, for micropollutants, and now we are trying to extend this knowledge also to new molecules like PFAS, and this is the subject of our communication, but also we are interested to the biological activity of particulate, and for example, we are trying to make a mutagenic test on particulate. We have published some works in recent years, and we can observe the linearity we have from the comparison of the concentration of pollutants and the biological activity is not always true. So we are trying to investigate this problem also with analysis of new pollutants like PFAS, like nitro PHAs. These molecules can give an important contribution to the hazard of particulate. And we hope to have an agreement, also an international agreement, to decide with another toxicity index, have a better comprehension of the air pollution situation. You can see the team of our the people working with the analysis of PFAS is very important because we have problems of not only analytical problems but also sampling. It is the core of this activity. You have been informed of the problems of PFAS was first involved in Veneto, and this that's the reason you can see an important activity as number of analyses in different environmental matrix in this region. For air samples, we are starting. We are working in progress, but we have been involved also in Piemonte for the presence of industrial sites and also background levels. You can see also in Veneto very important activity of control of human exposure for workers and also for people living in contaminated areas for serum analysis about 10,000 samples in 1 year. Let's start from the bottom. Let's start with the analytical point of view. We have a stronger cooperation with SAICS. This is the configuration of our instrument. There is 6,500 triple quadrupole. And for our application, it is important to us to have a PFAS delay column to avoid contamination, environmental contamination. And this is used is a reverse phased C18 to separate the target analytes from the target in from the analytes in the analytical sample. The column is placed between the solvent mixer chamber and the injector sample loop. Our conditions are described in the yellow box. You can say you can see the type of column flow, and rebombile phases are water and methanol and acetonitrile, 50% with the presence of ammonium acetate. The calibration curve. We have divided consideration with the general activity on PFAS and new molecules that in Veneto have been found at important levels, as you know, in water, some in water surface water, and it is a cyclic tensioactive isomer and other molecules recently present in industrial process. The ion ratio we have considered acceptable between the quantification ion and the qualification ion is on 30%. This is the list of compounds we have decided to determine. You can see there are alkyl carboxylic acids and also some carboxylate. And for each of our analytes, we work with internal standard level, as described previously for environmental samples in other presentations. Recently, Stockholm Convention has considered the introduction of some fluorinated compounds among substances defined as persistent organic pollutants. Also, the International Agency on Research on Cancer has classified one of these compounds, PFOA, in group 2B, a possible human carcinogen. We have found some environmental data in literature regarding PFOA in air samples in Japan and the USA with the background levels less than 1 nanogram per cubic meter in urban area in Japan and in the United States of always for PFOA. For evaluation of industrial impact in area at the perimeter of an important manufacturing plant is more than 100 grams per cubic meter. This for PFOA. We have to consider, you can see on the bottom of this slide, the actual situation. We are really in the working of progress. We have no Italian or European reference values at the moment. We have no official approved methods for sampling and analysis. For some molecules, for example, ADV, there are not yet certified materials and analytical standards. So we are at the start point of the process, as it was for water analysis 10 years ago. Now, our approach. Our approach has considered four options. Atmospheric depositions, with low volume sampling, and the determination of emissions. In particular, our colleague of Veneto has developed a method for this at the moment. You can see in the pictures the instruments for these four different options. Let's start with wet and dry deposition. We consider this approach in particular for long-term evaluation of emissions of big plants. For example, it is very important this activity for determination of micropollutants near waste engineering. What is the advantage of this technique? It's a long period of observation of exposure. Reavailability of analytical methods similar to the methods of water analysis, because we are speaking of wet deposition in particular. There are not important activity of sample extraction, but we have also some disadvantages, low sensitivity, and this data can be considered accumulation data. It is not possible to make direct comparison. Monitoring is very, very important, because you can see the unit of expression of result on the right of the slide. It is a unit of accumulation, not a unit of exposure. Anyway, we consider an important approach, because we have a good technique of sampling and analysis. It is very, very common, this technique, in environmental agencies for many, many applications. And we had some preliminary results to show. We have published in our site last month preliminary results with wet and dry deposition in area exposed and in area not exposed in Piemonte. And you can see for some of PFAS range from minimum and maximum concentration that there is an important presence of cyclic isomer of CC6O4, that it is considered as high priority analysis, analytical activity for water samples in the Po, in the Po Valley, you know. And there are only trace levels we have found for PFOA. This activity has been replicated every month in 2021, and it is in activity also for the monitoring station, were duplicated this year to assess the dispersion in different directions. In area not exposed, we have not revealed the presence of any PFAS. The second approach, the high volume sampling. This is activity very, very similar to the activity to determine micropollutant as PAH or dioxin. And the supports are quartz fiber filters or in series with the cartridge. And we need to make an important activity before sampling. And it is very Resuccinication in methanol, repurification of the cartridge with an extraction with EASE in methanol, and typical activity of micropollutants. What is the advantage of this technique? High flow, long period of observation, 24-72 hours is possible to make monitoring. Disadvantage, we need power supply, so we have to select sites not occasionally. And also another disadvantage, the complexity of the sample preparation. But we have concentration in air. It's possible to have a correlation with human exposure. We make in April and June with Veneto an inter-calibration test of monitoring with two teams, one of Piemonte and one of Veneto, on the same sites. Before in Piemonte, in two sites, in exposed area and in not exposed area, and the same in Veneto in June 22, to compare the results not only of the analytical performances, but also of the sampling performance. The preliminary results, we have to consider, we have to validate this method, but it is interesting to see that both agencies have obtained for the cyclic isomer CC6O4 range from 2 to 6 about nanogram cubic meter in area exposed, and also for ADV about 1 nanogram on cubic meter of this isomer, but not the other PFAS were inferior to the limit of detection. In we have to consider, you can see regarding the cyclic isomer, you can see a range of concentration in the not exposed area in Piemonte and in Veneto. We have a concentration varying from less than 0.1 nanogram to 0.6 nanogram. We have to try to understand that it is a work in progress, if it is a background environmental concentration or if it is a noise. We have still to understand in the last months of 2022, we are trying to make other monitoring activity to better understand risk tendency. The validation study has has considered the recovery of all the PFAS, not only the target of CC6O4 we have considered for monitoring. You can see very well the correlation with the molecular weight in the two different portion of our system, the filter with the higher molecular weight and cartridge with the lower molecular weight substances. We have also considered for a validation study the recovery with fortification with one of our PFAS, the cyclic CC6O4, and we can see a difference, and we have to study the results with the fortification, artificial fortification, with the recovery, tendency of recovery in the cartridge from 62 to 80%, with a total from 70 to 95, but you can see that we consider in a real sample, a situation changes. So we have to understand if it is reason, the introduction of our fortification in laboratory, that it is different than when we can find in environmental condition, or if there is also possible correlation with temperature, that this is a test considered in summer season. We can also have a different separation of the phases depending on temperature. It's also an hypothesis to study. The last approach was the air sampling tubes. That is very, very easy and common air monitoring activity. We are now testing this activity in particular for industrial hygiene monitoring, because we cannot use very heavy instrumentation in that situation. And in this case, we use XRD fiber filters, and sampling condition about 1 liter a minute, and with an analysis that is very, very common to other environmental situation. We tested also in this case the recovery, and it was very good because the, you can see, no, the first part of our cartridge has maintained the total amount of analyte. And what we can consider as an advantage, obviously there's no power supply, so it is very easy to prepare also in emergency conditions. We can consider this is very useful. Observation. Thank you very much.
Thank you for your presentation. Are there any questions?
Okay. Thank you very much. Great presentation. You mentioned at the beginning that you have some data about kind of non-linear relationship between amount of pollutants and biological response. I was wondering if you might wish to say something about that. Something.
Yes, we have observed that in the middle area of concentration, we have a good linearity of a correlation between the concentration of chemicals and the biological activity. Not the same situation at low level, because we expected a very low biological activity when we had a low concentration of particulate, a low concentration of PAH. But in some cases, in some areas in the Alps, we observed a not so low biological activity. As some secondary pollutant had an effect we are not in, at the moment able to understand. At higher concentration of particulate, biological activity is a little less than expected. So we have this situation. We have published some works about this phenomena. If you can write to me, I can send you this publication.
Maybe you can take this
Okay.
There are some questions in the chat.
Oh. Ci sono delle domande.
Dove le vediamo?
Ci pensa lui.
Ah.
Have you considered the analysis of FAS FTOH by thermal desorption?
Yes, we have. Thank you for the questions. I don't know. Thomas Zanchi, I can see. I don't know if it is a colleague of ARPA or other organization. We are trying to develop in 2023 this auction.